Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Today we have a topic with us, it's called hedging. Now, what exactly hedging is all about? See, in a simple way, if you want to understand what is hedging, it is like, you know, just covering your risk. You mitigate your risk. We'll understand this in a detailed format. See, hedging is basically like, you know, you can say an insurance. Insurance-like investment that protects you from the risk of any potential losses from your finances. Now, hedging is very similar to insurance because as we take insurance cover to protect ourselves from one or the other type of losses. For example, if we have an asset, we would like to protect it from floods, right? Or as human, it is not in our hands to directly protect it from floods. But in this case, we can take an insurance cover so that, you know, there is no any sort of damage to our property on account of floods, and we can get compensated for the same. So you can say that, you know, a hedge is an investment which has similar purpose as that of an insurance. Okay. And the purpose is to eliminate and to reduce the so-called risk by offsetting the potential loss. Now, if we are reducing the risk through hedging, then we might reduce the reward also at the same time. And in the case of the insurance, we pay a what we call as premium. And we might not even get any benefit from the premium if there is no flood during the tenure of the policy. Now, similarly, it isn't free either. So we have to pay a cost for which it reduces the overall reward that which we get. So normally, a hedge consists of taking an offsetting position in a related security, which offsets the risk of any adverse price movement. So it can be done through various financial instruments, such as, like, you know, I'll say forward contracts, you have a futures contract, we have options, and so on and so forth. Okay, now we will deal with the examples. See, most of the areas under the scope of business and finance can be covered under the hedging. Now, let us take an example of manufacturing organization, you know, that supplies its products to its local markets and is also involved in exports. So let's assume that its export sales form, let's say, 75% of its revenue. Okay, and the company will have an inflow of foreign currency as a primary source of revenue. So the value of the foreign currency may keep fluctuating, and it could lead to any sort of gains and losses. So in order to restrict these potential loss, the company might consider this through either of the following activities. Like, first, you know, you build your own factory in the foreign country so that, you know, goods manufactured and there can easily be sold without any foreign currency fluctuation. And this is one way to avoid the currency risk. Second, you know, they can also enter into a contract with the bank to sell this kind of foreign currency at a fixed rate by paying them fees or premium at the same time. Third, they can also enter into contract with major customers to pay them in their home currency. So company can hedge a given risk in more than one way, and the organization can decide which of the available option is the best given the availability of its resources and its constraints. Now we will deal with how does the hedging exactly works. How does the hedging works? Well, hedging can be done for items which have very sort of, you can say, fixed value, or item which have variable value. So there are different kinds, you know, hedging having a fixed value. I'll quickly run you through that. See, a fixed value is an item, you know, in which one item has a fixed value in your books of accounts and requires outflow of a fixed amount of cash in future. Like, let's say, you know, if you have taken a fixed interest loan is taken by the company with semi-annual fixed interest payment and fixed coupon non-convertible debentures are issued by the company at annual interest payments. So it is very obvious in this type of hedge that, you know, the amount and the rate is totally fixed much in advance, and this may or may not be in sync with the current market rates when the payment actually takes place. So this is the reason why the companies enter into hedging even for the fixed value items. Okay, and in the similar fashion, variable thing works. Now, variable is like, you know, let's say the company is paying fixed interest rate at 7%, right, to bank. So the company is paying to bank how much? 7%. So the company will receive over here LIBOR plus 0.5% per annum of the interest, right? So this is completely opposite. Company will pay bank 7% and bank will pay company L plus LIBOR plus 0.5, that is fluctuating rate. So it is a fixed item and variable item having fluctuating cash flows at the point of time, right? So variable interest loans, this are generally based on some what we call as the benchmark rates plus a sort of, you can say, a fixed rate, as you can see, 0.5%. And there is also involvement of the forex related exchange transactions. Variable convertible debentures are also, you can say, part of it. Convertible debentures. Okay, now we'll take an example for hedging example, so that, you know, we have a clear idea regarding what exactly is working here. Now let's say that an organization has taken a loan of how much? Let's say $10 million, which has semi-annual payments, which has what? Semi-annual interest payments at LIBOR plus 0.5. So the current LIBOR rate is 7% per annum, but the organization believes that the LIBOR rate is going up. 7% is the interest rate, and they think that the LIBOR is increasing, rate is going to increase in the near future. So the organization enters into contract with the bank that it will receive L plus 0.5% per annum, and it will pay 7% to bank, right? So the cash flow will be worked out something like this. If we move down, we'll get some data over here. The LIBOR rate in case of case A is 7.5%, and in the case 2 is 6.5. So we'll discuss case A first. The fixed age of LIBOR here is fixed percentage of LIBOR is 0.5. The rate of LIBOR is 7.5. So the total interest comes down to 8%. It is 7.5 plus 0.5. Now the interest payments, right? Interest payments are closely around 8 lakh on this particular amount, that is 10 million. Right? So in case A, the interest rate payable to the bank is 7%. So the actual coupon payment is what? $8 lakh. The organization will pay to the bank is how much? 7% of this. 7%. I'll just add this amount from here. And less the organization will receive from the bank how much? $8 lakh. So the net payment is going to be the total 8 plus 7, 15 less 8, that is 7 lakh. And the same case goes over here. It's just the change of the amount. So by that, you can also calculate for 6.25%. 6.75 is the total amount. You can directly multiply this with the amount, the interest rate payable to the bank. So actual coupon payment is how much? It is 675. The organization will pay to the bank how much? It is going to be the same 7 lakh. An organization will receive how much? C. Right. You must have got the answer now. So this is how it exactly works for the variable. So from the above, organization, you know, has restricted its outgoing of 7 lakh irrespective of the market rates. C. Irrespective of the market rates, it has stopped its risk. And this is opposite completely of the fixed value hedge, where they let go the fixed outgoing payment and convert it into the flexible payments. Now, many companies around the globe, you know, they want to buy equipments, or probably they want to buy a loan on such equipments. So they do not usually go for fixed, because, you know, fixed, that is available from the market, 11% or 8% or 7%, whatever may be the case. But they want a slightly lesser interest rate by which they can survive, or probably they can save some cost. So for that, they need to go for the fluctuating rate And over here, they also need to hedge the currency. Mind it, you need to hedge the currency. You just cannot take the loan on LIBOR. You have to hedge the currency also here.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.